Yo, what's up, guys? This is Rawtek, live from Bali, Hotel Barong. Today, I'm going to take you through one of my new tracks from the Disco Art Show EP. Just going to look through the track, and I'm going to break down more or less the vocal chop drop and just how I work and how I take samples and just can do the shit with them. All right, let's go. Let's get into it. So this is Boho Future from the Disco Art Show EP, and... All right, let's get into it. So, the original vocal sample that I found, which actually started the song, is this. I got it off Splice, just like an R&B vocal. Sounds like this. 'Cause I'm so in love with you, I don't need you to change your sublime, sublime, sublime. So yeah, just really good vocal. Just love the cadence and everything. Just sounds really, really nice. Just pitched it up a little bit. Sounds like this. And then for the breakdown, actually, we got somebody to re-record. Brong found a vocalist to re-record this vocal for the breakdown, just so it matches the melody a little bit more. But for the drop, I still have this original sample and just chopped it up, and it sounds like this. So yeah, so if we just go into it here, you can hear like the first hit is just the U part. This part. So yeah, I'll go through the vocal usually, and I'll like, for an example, just open up a new audio track. If you haven't noticed, I'm on Ableton 9 because I'm a weirdo, and I tried 10, didn't like it for some reason, just worked faster in 9, but yeah. So let's see here. So like, I'll go through the vocal. Pitch it up, whatever, do whatever I gotta do. And I'll just like, oh, I like that U, so I'll just put it down here. And then keep going through it. I like this J part, so like put that there. You know, fix it later, warp it. Go in here, just move it over. And then get the fades right there. Just match it up there. And then it'll be like this. And then you can hear that's the first hit on the drop. And then same thing throughout the entire thing. Just keep going through the vocal, finding cool little parts that I really like. Just putting them down here and just messing with it. Just trying to find a pattern that works, that flows really nicely. So like, this is my favorite part of the vocal, this change. So grab that change. And then you can hear in the drop. I don't know why, but it's my favorite part of the drop when she says change. And then I don't know if you can hear, but there's also a like vocoder vocal chop, which is down here. So if I take off the vocoder, it was actually a different pattern, vocal chop drop, but it was a different pattern, but with the vocoder on it, it just sounded good. I actually really like this part. It has just like a little bit of attitude. And then you add the vocoder and it sounds like this. So it's being channeled to this, the sample, the disco like melody here, but that's muted so that this can like be more present, and by itself it's not like clashing with it. So it has a little bit of the sample in there, and then the vocal chop makes it a little bit more bouncy, and sounds like some old Daft Punk kind of stuff. Again, without the vocoder. Got some OTT, some chorus, some amp, some weird ass EQs, the vocoder, the resonator, and then I have the reverb here, compressor, side chaining it to the kick, and then this auto filter just comes in later, and then a saturator there, and then a final like just EQ, get out any extra low end that might be coming through. I don't know, the way I work, it's really weird. I just keep fucking adding shit and then I just fix it later, because just how my brain works. I just need to like get the idea out, and then once I get the idea out and starts to sound kind of cool, then I'll clean stuff up. But yeah, so the vocal chop, it's really fun to just make vocal chop drops, because you're just really, instead of making like a lead, you're using like a vocal and messing with the parts to make it kind of, it gives like the lead of the drop more of a human personality, which I really like. And you know, vocal chop shit, it really works too, because I mean, if you've ever heard like Kanye's music, he uses a lot of vocals and vocal chops and samples and stuff, because for some reason it just has like that personality that carries to people in a different way than just like a synth would or something. Can kind of like connect with it more, I guess. I don't know. Not always, but yeah. It works. And then the second half of the drop here, I have a lower pitched one going under it. And then they're just layered on top of each other. So essentially there's three vocal chops going on at the same time. One has a vocoder, one is low pitch, one is normal pitch. So I have compressor on here as a side chain, but I also, because I'm a weirdo and I'm super meticulous about stuff like this, I go in with the fades and I sidechain manually each part, because I feel like certain parts of the vocal sound better with a bigger sidechain than other parts. Literally, I'll just go in and I'll mess with each fucking sidechain here, like this. And I'll go in and just manually do each part. Like this one doesn't even have the fade sidechain. I don't know why, it just sounded better. That's the change vocal. And I didn't want it to like go too much of a dip right there. I just liked how it rode out. So it doesn't go like this. I mean, that sounds good too, whatever. But yeah, so I'll go in and I'll just freaking do each sidechain manually, even though it has a compressor on it too. It just adds more of a organic feel, I guess. It's not like a very robotic sidechain. It's not like each hit is the same sidechain. Yeah, it's really tedious, but it's just the way I like to do it. And you know, this is the kind of shit that nobody's gonna ever realize, but when I listen to it, I'm just like, oh yeah, that sounds good like that. And then we'll get into the breakdown here. Oh wait, this is the actual outro part of the drop. So yeah, this one, it's not as chaotic, the vocal chops. It's literally just the phrases repeating. And it just has like that classic disco style of, you know, suspended happiness, just repeating. And then the breakdown here, it's my favorite part of the vocal, the change part. this is the riser part. So you go to this transpose here. I put it on complex. Sometimes it sounds different if you put it on complex pro, but in this case, I liked it on complex. And then I pitch it up. I think it's plus 3 semitones. And then at the very end, it goes up a lot more to, should be 12 or, yeah, 12. So a whole octave up. Ends on a whole octave. So like in the beginning of the riser, it goes up only a little bit. So it creates a little bit of tension. And then at the very end, it just like fucking goes all the way up. And then obviously it's sidechained to the kick. So yeah, this vocal chop, I can't think of the word, but I fucking copied it over from the first drop and then I chopped it up a little bit more to create some more variation. And this one has like more pauses. It's not so like continuous. It just it's more like it has a bounce to it. And then I have some strings under it too. Classic disco sounding strings. So in this case, like, you know, second drop, you want to have a little bit of variation. Gives the listener like a journey rather than just copy and paste. The song progresses and the drops are different, so it gives you something more interesting to listen to. Generally, I'd like to keep the most interesting one as the first drop, because you want to get your listeners like when they first listen to it. And then the second is just like a complementary pattern to the first drop, so it's not like nuts, like crazy different. It's just like complementing the first drop. But the vocoder is the same because it just carries it really well. Oh, that's the sub. Where's the vocoder? Here it is. So yeah, the main thing I'd like to say about vocal chop drops is just go through the vocal, just find the best parts. To be honest, I really like vowel sounds like ahs and ohs and stuff that starts with a B, like buh, I don't know, just sounds cool. Or D, like hard consonants. But yeah, like anything that's just like singing with like a vowel, like a strong vowel like part sounds better. I don't know if that makes sense. Like if I were to make a new drop here, I like this part. It's just like an ah sound. This part's a little wonky, so I wouldn't choose that. This U sounds fucking sick. That part's weak. It's just like the eh at the end, so I wouldn't use that. But like this part's cool because it has like this little stutter, so you could just like add that into something. Like, or even just use this jit. Like if you go through here, it's like the same concept here. It adds that bounce when it has like that jit. Also, like I have these parts that are it's just the sample like playing up. So it doesn't sound like it's too like, not like chaotic, but it has like some parts that are still like the original vocal phrase, just so it sounds like she's still singing something and it's not just like fucking chops. So you could even like sing along to this vocal chop, like, and then you get to change and then blah 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 blah, EDM blah 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 blah. Right. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Just a little breakdown of how this works into this Boho Future track. I really like this track. It was really like I made it maybe in like a couple weeks or something. Came out really like fast. And that's like always the best when you don't overthink shit too much. You just kind of get in there and things start coming together because you're just having a good time making it. I guess this is like outro. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this little breakdown of Boho Future. The song is out now on Barong Family, and my first production stream, actually. And I'll see you guys again soon. Peace.